Adding 3D elements to videos is becoming really popular these days. Some video editors like to use software like Blender, Maya, Cinema 4D, amongst many other 3D software to create 3D elements in their own scenes. But today we're going to be breaking it down in a much easier to use fashion. Now, the reason I'm calling this a fake 3D tutorial is because we're actually not using any 3D objects within this tutorial. We're not using any 3D software. We're not using any .objs. We're going to kind of create the look of 3D without actually using anything that's 3D. Here on my timeline, I have a clip from a music video that I've been editing. And I do want to mention that if you're an editor or a filmmaker or an artist with some video clips that you wouldn't mind having some special effects thrown on, feel free to contact me on Instagram. I'm always looking for new projects and collaborations, especially with those of you who watch my videos. So if that sounds interesting to you, make sure to check out my Instagram link down below. On this music video clip, we do have some nice depth already. So you can see here in the background, we have some trees. Here in the middle ground, we have this guy drinking the pink Sprite bottle. And then we have the artist here in the foreground. So I thought this would be a really cool scene to kind of add some floating Sprite bottles here in the background. Now, I do recommend that whatever you plan on adding these elements to in your scene, it has to kind of match the vibe of the scene. So for example, for me, I'm going to use floating Sprite bottles because there's a Sprite bottle in this scene already. Maybe you're doing like a car video shoot, you want to have some cars floating around in the background. Whatever it is, just make sure that kind of matches the vibe of your scene. All I'm going to do with this clip is duplicate it here on my Premiere Pro timeline, right click on this new clip and hit replace with After Effects composition. Now here in After Effects, we're going to do a little motion tracking. So with my layer selected, I'm going to come up here to Effects and Presets, and I'm going to type in Mocha AE. Now this is a built-in tracker within After Effects, and I think it does a much better job than the stock tracker that's within After Effects. Click on this big Mocha button. So now with the Mocha software opened, what I'm going to do is basically identify a point within this video clip that's going to remain throughout the clips. So what I mean by that is, like, look at these trees here in the background, especially this spot in the trees. It's there the entire time of the clip as I kind of go through it. That part of the tree remains in every frame. So that's a good tracking point for us here in Mocha. What I'm gonna do is come up to my X spline tool, and I'm just gonna kind of create a little circle type object track around this part of the tree. I'm gonna close that track point. Now here on my first frame, I'm gonna come to my tracking options and just select track forwards. Now what Mocha is going to do is going to track the point that we selected, and it's going to create tracking data to then which we can apply our Sprite bottles that we're going to have floating around in the background and have them move with the camera movement. So once our motion track is done, I can just kind of scroll through my timeline just to see, make sure that it does a good job. And you can see there, it's just staying highlighted over that area that we wanted, right? So that's great. This is a good track for us. Come up here to the save button in Mocha. I'm just going to hit it one time, exit out of Mocha. And now here in my layers panel, I'm going to right click and create a new null object. Select our original clip, come up to the tracking data under Mocha and select create track data. We're just gonna hit okay. And it's going to create track data for the point that we just tracked within Mocha. Export this track data to our new null object. Select the corner pin, change it to corner pin with motion blur, and hit apply export. Now this is going to apply all the motion track data to this null object, to which we can then parent our Sprite bottles to. Take the Sprite bottle PNG that I downloaded from Google. Now, it's important to use PNGs because they have a transparent background, as you can see. Position this Sprite bottle here towards the left of the frame and kind of this opening right here. All you have to do from here is just parent your Sprite bottle to the null object. And you can see as I play it back, the Sprite bottle now does not change position even as the camera moves throughout this scene. So again, it really only took a few steps to get to this point. Now what we wanna do is blend this in kind of with the environment. So what I'm gonna do from here is take this Sprite bottle, we're just gonna shrink it down with the scale, make it look like it's farther away in the background. So what I'm gonna do from here is come to my effects and presets, type in an effect called camera lens blur, and we're going to apply that to this Sprite bottle. You can see that adds a little bit of blur to this Sprite bottle already, but I want it to be a little bit more blurry, kind of like the trees here in the background. So let's just take the blur radius of this bottle up to like an 8, and that's just gonna blur our bottle quite a bit. So now it looks like it's kind of more in the background, right? So pretty cool. Now what I'm gonna do with this layer is duplicate it by hitting Command D, and I'm just going to increase the size of this new sprite bottle. We're going to take the camera lens blur down quite a bit. Let's go to like a 2, and we'll put this one a little bit closer to the artist. So this one is a little bit bigger. It's gonna give the illusion of it being closer to the foreground in our shot. And then what I'm gonna do is duplicate this layer and make an even bigger sprite bottle here on the left side. So you can start to see the depth that we're creating. We're gonna have this one kind of really far up close to the shot. This one's kind of in the middle and this one's way in the background. But with this new sprite bottle, I'm gonna take the camera lens blur down to a 1, just so that it has a very small touch of blur. Now what I'm gonna do is just animate these sprite bottles so that they move a little bit differently from each other. You can see they're all kind of facing the same direction. Shift click all my sprite bottles, and I'm gonna hit R on my keyboard to pull up our rotation property. And I'm going to make a keyframe there at the beginning, and here at the end, I can make another keyframe for all those layers. On the end keyframes, let's actually change the rotation values of these bottles so that they're all kind of rotating differently, as you can see there. So now as this scene moves, these bottles are actually going to rotate, and it just helps to add a little bit more movement within the scene, make the bottles look a little bit more interesting. The last thing that I noticed is that he's drinking a pink Sprite, right? So let's add some variety to these Sprite bottles by typing in HLS, using a color balance HLS, and changing the hue of some of these Sprite bottles to make them look a little bit more interesting, a little bit different, a little bit more unique. So I'm just gonna make this one, let's make this one like more of a red, kind of match the vibe of the bottle he's drinking. Add a little flicker to these bottles. So I'm just gonna type in flicker, use sapphire flicker on each of these bottles. I'm just going to highlight all my layers, right click on them and pre-compose them. Just going to hit okay on this new pre-composition. And now that they're all combined into one layer, I'm going to add RSMB, which is real smart motion blur. This is going to kind of blur everything a little bit more. It's gonna add a little bit more camera blur to the scene. I'm just gonna turn it up just a little bit more. So you can see here, our final clip looks pretty freaking awesome. All the bottles stay kind of in the same spot. They're all hovering. Just looks really trippy, right? Adds a little bit more eye candy to the shot. Now, if you wanted to take this even further, we could color correct each of the bottles so that they look a little bit different from where they're placed in the scene. I really hope that this inspires some of you guys to start thinking outside the box a little bit more when it comes to adding eye candy to your videos, creating kind of these 3D depth illusions within your footage, and just spicing things up a little bit. So make sure to type any questions or comments you have down below this video. If you're a video editor who is maybe interested in adding some new overlays, some transition presets, maybe some title templates to your next video, make sure to check out the links down below and download the free pack on VentureVisuals.com. It's got some samples from every pack on my website, which you can then use to elevate your next visual today. So if that sounds exciting to you, make sure to check out the links down below in the description. And as always, guys, I really appreciate everybody for tuning into the channel. We're so close to 30,000 subscribers. It's like a dream come true to me. I never expected this channel to be where it's at today. And it's all thanks to you guys and our hard work and our collaborations. I'm really excited for what the future holds for this community and this channel, man. You guys are awesome. Thank you for always supporting me. And until next time, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.